What's up, guys? In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make this little dingleberry right here. Ah! Son of a... There you go. It's like a mini bladed jig. I've caught little bass, crappie. A buddy of mine in East Tennessee says smallmouth love them. I'm sure you can catch just about anything on these. For this project, I'm going to be using the Do-It Mold round head jig. For these jigs, I'm going to use 1/16 and 1/8 ounce. You're obviously going to need a lead pot. For the hooks, I'm going to be using little nasties. These are basically like a Ned Rig style jig hook, but they have a sickle end to them. I use these for my Ned Rigs now too. They're just I feel like you get a lot better hook set with this sickle style hook. You're also going to need some number one Colorado blades. Don't get real expensive blades because we're going to have to drill holes in these. And it kind of messes up the finish of it. So you're better off. I think I got these off eBay. If I compare these blades to the size chart in the back of my tackle catalog, these are actually closer to a 2. So you got some laying around, just kind of eyeball it, but these are the ones I got. And you're also going to need some size 1 duo lock snaps. Same ones I use for my chatterbaits, for my bladed jigs. They're just really small. All right, you're obviously going to need some other things, some hand tools, a drill, a real small drill bit. And I use a pick to open up the gap for these hooks because you kind of got to finesse these. The wire on these hooks is a lot smaller than like a bigger size bladed jig, so you gotta be careful not to break the eye. But we'll go over that when we get to it. You don't have to powder coat these if you don't want to. You could leave them just lead colored, but I'm gonna powder coat them too and bake them on. All right, let's get to it. Okay, for the 16th ounce, I'm gonna use a number 2 little nasty, and for the 8th ounce, I'm gonna use a 1/0. There you go. Now with these, you kind of got to work fast, just like the bladed jigs, and try to gap that hook while it's still warm. Go ahead and cut these sprues off to kind of get them out of our way. I just gap these hooks. All right, the way I gap these is with a pick. Basically, I just kind of get it started in the hole because these picks are pretty sharp. I try to push it in there until it's tight, and then lay the edge of the eye on something like this vise and kind of tap it in. It don't take much with these small hooks, so be careful. You don't want to break it. That's why it's best to work when that lead heats that hook up. Alright, you see how it's gapped now? And always test it with one of your blades. And all you need is just to go in there like that. If it goes in there, it lets you know that that's good enough. All right, go ahead and do the other one. If you got something wood, like I got this table right here, you could actually just use it. You don't mind putting a hole in it. There you have it. So these two are ready to be filed down. All right, now that you've got your hooks gapped, you can go ahead and take your file and file them down. It don't take much on these round head jigs. There you go. Ready for powder coat. All right, let's do these chartreuse. So you're gonna take it and heat it up. You gotta be careful with these real small ones because you'll screw your lead up quick. It only needs to get a little warm. All right, dip it in. Try to keep from getting any kind of powder coat on the eye of your hook. If you can, I know it's kind of hard with these small ones, but that's where his fluid bed really, really, really comes in handy. All right, if you got anything on your hook eyes, now's the time, once they've cooled down a little bit, to go ahead and try to scrape it off. If you wait till you bake it on, it's gonna be hard to get off. It don't have to be perfect. Just get the bulk of it off. I actually did a pretty good job about keeping these pretty clean. All right, once you get them cleaned up, go ahead and load them in your oven and bake them. I bake them just like I would any other lure for about 30 minutes at 350 degrees. And now we need to get these blades right. These blades are concave, right? They kind of make a little bowl. Well, we need them to be flat. And the way I figured to do that is you're gonna need something. You could probably do it on the floor. I'm gonna use this little anvil part of this vise. Take something like an old towel, or I got an old sock right here. Put it over it. I got the belly up of this blade. And now put your sock on it or whatever. Take you a hammer. What you're gonna do is hit it real hard and try to flatten it out. Sure, my neighbors love that. It's 4 o'clock in the morning. All right, so that's pretty close. You put the sock over it, try to keep from scratching that blade. Let's hit it a couple more times. All right. See how it's pretty much flat now? That's what we need. All right. Now what we gotta do is put some more holes in here for our snap. And what you can do, originally is what I did, is I just got a regular bladed jig blade and kind of went off of it. I just lined up the hole, tried to make sure it was even in the back, and then just took a marker and marked the two holes and then drilled them out. Now, if you don't have one of these, I'll try to take a picture of what I got going on here with in front of a tape measure to get you an idea of where the holes need to be for this size blade. I actually kept my very first one I did, and I use it now as my template. So after you get your first one made, keep it, and then you just slide your blades on top of them and take a Sharpie and then just mark your holes. What I found best to do is to take a nail or a screw, something that's got a pretty sharp point on it, and put it right in the center of your marks, and then tap it. That'll give you a good pilot hole for when you screw the holes in here. All right, now this is ready to be drilled or dropped on the floor. All right, now you're ready to drill the hole. I believe this is a 5/64 drill bit. All right, so what I do is I take a clamp and I clamp it to a piece of wood. I'm using this table. And then just drill your holes. It's easy once you get the little pilot hole. There you have it. It kind of does bugger up the back of it a little bit, where you drilled through, and it could kind of cause it to get a little bent. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna hammer it one more time. It's all good now. Now you ain't gonna have just a perfect clear finish on these with all that hammering, but it'll be okay. All right, now once your jig is done baking and cooled off, next thing to do is go ahead and attach your blade. And all you do is obviously just slide it in there. And I found the best way to close that gap up is just use a pair of pliers, because the wire on these hooks is pretty thin anyways. And just squeeze it tight. And just make sure it's closed up enough to where that blade isn't gonna back out. All right, your next step is to add your snap. All right, you're gonna start with the hole closest to the hook. push it in, and then come back through the bottom. And good, you take some, your pliers and try to push the point of that through your hole like that, and then just snap it. All right. You pretty much put whatever trailer on these that you want. I pour these 2-inch rippers. It's a do-it mold. That's what I like to use on it. Go ahead and thread one on here and show y'all what it looks like. Been real effective for me. But I mean, you could use a grub if you wanted to. Deep Creek, I got these Deep Creek 2-inch grubs. I put one on another one and it looks real good. I'm gonna have to try this one out. Reminds me a lot of a beetle spin. There you have it. The mini bladed jig. If you happen to try this little project, let me know how it turns out. Let me know what you catch with it. You could obviously do this with any kind of hook that's in the same style. You could try it with a Ned rig. That might be pretty cool, a bladed Ned rig. If you try that, let me know. As always, I really appreciate you guys watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.